Hi everyone. Today we are going to see the question and answer of internal combustion engine. Okay. So first question is, what is internal combustion engine? Okay. The internal combustion engine is an engine in which the combustion of fuel take place inside the engine cylinder. Okay. So fuel uses petrol, diesel, or the gas means CNG. Okay. Now the second question is, what is the function of piston ring? Okay. We see that there are three types of pins or rings are available in the piston. Okay. So there are two sets. Okay. So two sets of piston rings mounted on the piston. The function of the upper ring is provide the airtight seal. Okay, and to prevent the leakage of the burn gases to the lower person. And the function of the lower rings is to provide the effective seal to prevent the leakage of the oil into the engine cylinder. It means one is the piston for the exhaust gas leakage and to prevent the exhaust gas leakage. And the second one is to prevent the oil in the combustion chamber. Okay, it is called as a oil ring. Okay. So third question is, what is the function of flywheel? What is the function of flywheel? The function of flywheel is to store the energy during the power stroke. Okay, and return during the other stroke, and thereby the maintain the constant speed. So the constant speed will be maintained during the combustion process or the running of the internal combustion engine. Fourth question is, what is wall timing diagram? Okay, we see that the wall timing diagram is used to opening and closing of the valve, timing of opening and closing of the valve. So a valve timing diagram is the graphical representation of the exit movement in the sequence of operation at the two valves, inlet and exhaust valve, open and close, as well as the firing of the fuel, in generally expressed in the terms of angular position of the crankshaft. Okay, as I already said that it is the representation of the graphical when exhaust and the inlet valve will open. Okay. Now we will see the fifth question. The fifth question is, what is clearance volume? Okay. What is clearance volume? What is clearance volume, stroke volume, and the compression ratio? The clearance volume is the space between the head and the pistons when the piston is at the TDC, means at the top dead center, is known as the clearance volume. Means whatever space is available during the cylinder above the piston head, when the cylinder is at the top dead center, means at the TDC, it is called as a clearance volume. Second one is the stroke volume. The volume displaced by the piston as it's moved from one dead center to the other dead center, means the top dead center to the bottom dead center, is called as a stroke volume or the swept volume. Means when the piston is traveled from TDC to BDC, whatever volume is covered during this stroke is called as a swept volume. Okay. Now the compression ratio. Next one is a compression ratio. The ratio of total cylinder volume, means stroke volume plus clearance volume, to the clearance volume. Okay. So compression ratio is denoted by the stroke volume plus the clearance volume divided by the clearance ratio. So R is equal to, so R is equal to Vs plus Vc divided by Vc, where the Vs is the swept volume, Vc is the compression volume, and the Vc is the compression, R is the compression ratio. Okay, clear? Now we will see the sixth question. So what are the function of fuel injection system and CI engine? The answer is the function. There are the five functions: to meter the correct quantity of fuel to be injected. The first function is to meter or measure the correct quantity of the fuel to be injected. The second one is atomize the fuel into the fine particles. Third one is time the fuel injection. Fourth one, control the rate of the fuel injection. And the fifth one, properly distributed the fuel in the combustion chamber. Air injection system and airless or the solid injection system. So first, in air injection system, the liquid fuel is sprayed into the engine cylinder by the means of compressed air. While in the airless or the solid injection system, liquid fuel is injected into the engine cylinder at the high pressure by the means of fuel pump. While second, in the air injection system, it required multi-stage air compression, which caused increase in engine weight and reduces net power output. It is used rarely. While airless or the solid injection system, this system is used more common because of there is no multi-stage combustion, so the weight of the engine will be lesser. Now, 8th question. So what is carburetor? We see the carburetor is used only in the SI, means the petrol engine only. Okay. So what are the function of carburetor? Okay. So the process of the atomize the fuel and the mixing of fuel with the air at required proportion of the SI engine is called the carburation, and the device which is processed take place is called the carburetor. Means the proper mixing of the air and fuel is mixed in the carburetor, and this process is called as a carburation, and whichever equipment is used is called as a carburetor. Okay. So next is the, now we will see the difference between air cooling system and the water cooling system. Okay, in air cooling system, the design of the system is very much simple and less costly. So in the water cooling system, the design of the system is complex and more costly. The mass of the cooling system is very less. The mass of the cooling system is very much more. The fuel combustion is more in the air cooling system, while the fuel consumption is less. Its install and maintenance is very easy and less costly. Its installation and maintenance is very difficult and more costly. There is no danger of leakaging of or freezing of coolant. There is the danger of leakaging or the freezing of the coolant. It doesn't require any coolant. It required the coolant. Next, we will see the what are the function of carburetor. The first function, to maintain a small reserve of petrol at a constant level in the float chamber. The first is to maintain the fuel or petrol in the carburetor or the float chamber. Okay. To atomize the liquid fuel and mix it with the air, means to proper air fuel mixer, and to supply the air fuel vaporized mixture at a correct ratio according to the engine requirement. Okay. So next, what are the difference between the carburetor and fuel injector? The carburetor is used in the spark ignition system, while fuel injector is used in the compressor ignition system. Okay, means carburetor is used in the SI engine, while fuel injector is used in the CI engine. Carburetor supplied air fuel mixture into the engine cylinder, while fuel injector supply only fuel into the engine cylinder. So next question is, what is scavenging? Scavenging is a process to removal of the exhaust gas from the cylinder or the combustion chamber. Okay, the process of removing burn gases from the combustion chamber of the engine cylinder is defined as the scavenging. What is the purpose of spark plug? The purpose of spark plug is to conduct the spark into the combustion chamber, due to which the ignition of air fuel mixture take place. Okay, the purpose of spark plug is to conduct the spark into the combustion chamber, due to the which the ignition of air fuel mixture take place. Okay.